In this fifth part of how to convert a website into an Android app playlist, we are going to create a splash screen for our app, which will have a great animation. So first of all, we had created a new activity by right clicking on this Java folder, and after that click on new, and here is our activity, and click on empty activity. Then you have to give the activity name splash screen, as we are creating splash screen. Then you will have this error, this, and give our layout ID, sorry, layout name. Then click on finish. Here we had already created it. So here is our splash screen, and here is our splash screen underscore, sorry, activity splash screen dot XML file. After that, we are going to come on manifest file, and this intent filter will be here. Here it will be. Then you have to copy or cut it and then paste it into this splash screen dot splash screen activity. Then now it is become now main activity, means our application will start from this activity. After that, we are going to design our layout. So first of all, we had created or we had added the background to our constraint layout of our splash screen, that is color primary. After that, we are going to add the text view to it. So text view and its width will be wrap content, and its height also will be wrap content. After that, we are going to assign its ID, and its ID will be title, so it can be easily recognizable. Now here we are going to pass the string, so text, and here is our app name, which is Fiverr. So now we are going to add, here we are going to add some font text size. So text size will be 36 SP. And after that, we are going to click on it. We need our text color. So text color is white. So color or Android white. This, then we are going to say click on it and click this button to here, then match it here, then add it here. After that, we have to make it center. So here it is in center. Now we are going to increase its height. So font size will be 48 SP. So here it is. Now we are going to add some font. So first of all, click on design tab and then come to the font family. So find the font family from here, and here it is. So click on it, and then you have to click on more fonts. After that, you will find this bunch of fonts you can use. Here we are going to use any of that. So let's search for this. Okay, so here we are going to use this bold version of this and click on OK. After clicking on OK, you will find that our text has changed from this. So now we are going to add that font. So font family is this. Okay, so here we had added our font family, and here we are creating the app for fiverr.com. so here we had written Fiverr. After that, we are going to assign or add some subtitle. So first of all, copy this whole code and paste it here. After that, close it so it become easy. Now change its ID. So ID will be subtitle. After that, we are going to decrease its text size to 36 SP. And we are going to change the string to, let's say, simply write your subtitle. You can write anything instead of this subtitle. So let's again decrease its size so it may be 24 SP. Yeah, it is now. So now again we are going to use this constraint. So after that, align this to as per your need. So we are going to copying and this. Now we are going to align this to with this. So here we get our constraint with our fiverr.com. Now add some margin to it so it may get some space. So margin will be 5 dp, and again with here margin top knot margin is equal to 5 dp. So here we got some space. Now we are going to add some credit. So who had made this app? So here we are going to write another text, and here we are going to write credit. After that we are going to change the text. So write by and remove this constraints. So here is our work. So write by, then create this slash and type end. So we will get on next or next line. So write Android or your brand name or your name. So Android tutorials, this is our channel name. Please make sure you subscribe this channel to learn more interesting videos. So here it is, and now we are going to say is gravity to center. So here our bike come in center, and then we are going to add some constraints to it. So this is from with here, this with here, and then top constraint with your title below, and its lower will be from here. So add these constraints as per your need. So here we had created, so instead of this subtitle, let's write best freelancing site. So best freelancing site, then we are going to add some animation to our file. So here our splash screen had completed. You can also add your logo or Lutie animations, which is best to work for clients. We will also see that splash screen in our upcoming videos. So please like this video. Now we are going to add our animations. So first of all, right click on race folder and then create new directory. Then simply write anim. Don't use capital words. After that we have to create two animations. So right click on it and select animation resource file. After that we are going to name it bottom anim. After that use root element to set and create this file. Then you will get this file. Then now write our animation. So our animation will be translate, then from y delta it will be 0%. Then write from x delta it will be 50%. Then write duration. We will add duration to it so it will be not come in auto suggestion. So simply duplicate it and write duration, and its duration will be 150 1500. Then close this translate. After that, we are going to add alpha to it. And alpha will be from alpha will be 0.1. And the value of 2 alpha will be 1.0. Then we are going to add duration. So copy the code of duration. It will be not auto generated, so you need to write it. We had also close our alpha. So here we had added translate, and from y delta the value is 0%, from x delta the value is 50%, and the duration is 1500. Then we had added alpha. From alpha is 0.1 and 2 alpha is 1.0, and again we had added duration to it. Now this was our bottom animation. So now we are going to add side animation. So right click on it and say side anim. After click on OK. So here our animation is generated. Now we are going to write translate. Then from x delta will be minus 50%. After that, from y delta will be 0%. After that, we are going to add duration. So simply duplicate it and write here. Control D is the shortcut key to duplicate a line. So duration is equal to 1500. After that, close it, and we are going to write alpha. So alpha is same as our bottom animation. So first of all, we are going to write from alpha. From alpha will be 0.1, then 2 alpha value will be 1.0, and then we are going to write duration. So Control D to duplicate it. Now duration and here duration will be 1500. Then close it. Here our animation is now ready. Now it's time to set animation on our splash screen. So let's get started with adding animation. So first of all, let's close all the other tabs, and now in this we are going to declare our text view. So first of all, write text view. So text view will be title, subtitle and credit. After that, we are going to write animation, and animation will be bottom anim and side anim. Okay, so here is our, we had created the objects for our text view and animation, and now we are going to create at what time our, how much time our splash screen should show. So first of all, write int, then write splash timer is equal to 3000. So close it, and this is for 3 seconds. After that, we are going to create the text view. So here is casting for text view. After that, we are going to cast all the text view. So text title we will find view by id, r.id.title. So after that, control D to duplicate that and write here subtitle subtitle. Then instead of this title, we are going to write credit. After casting our text, you now time to cast our animation. So first of all, write bottom anim is equal to animation utils dot load animation. Now pass the context this and then our animation. So r dot anim dot bottom anim. Then again write it for our side animation. So side animation is equal to animation utils dot load animation this comma r dot anim dot side anime. Then close it. So here we had declared our animation. Now it's time to set the animation. So title dot set animation. So here you can write any of the animation. So we are using first bottom anim. Now to create the amazing animation, we are going to use subtitle dot set animation. Now side anim. After that we are going to add the animation to a credit. So set animation and here again bottom animation. After that we are going to add, so we can move from this activity to another activity and this activity will not open again. So first of all, create new handler and then you have to set dot post delete, then write new runnable. This will create a override run method and also a error. So to remove error, we had created this timer or a seconds. So write that in after this curly bracket and write splash timer. So error will be gone and close this. After that we are going to write intent is equal to new or new intent. So here we are going to use intent is equal to new intent get application context comma then our main activity dot class. So here we had created our new intent and now we are going to write start activity intent. After that we are going to finish this activity. So here is finish method. So here our finish method is done. Now our animation is ready to work. So first of all, we are going to connect our Android device with our Android Studio. Then we will see how it animation work. So here is our Android device. So now we are going to run our Android device. Run our app in our Android device. So here it is running. Let's wait for it, the result. Now let me remind you what we had done in this video. So first of all, we had created the new activity by right clicking on the Java folder, then new, and then we had created empty activity and given the name splash screen. After that we had added this to animation and this automatic generated splash screen folder. Here we had created our text views for our title, subtitle and our credit. After that, we had added or casted it in our splashscreen.java. So here it is. We had created text view, subtitle, text view for title, subtitle, and credit. After that, we had added the animations to our folder. Till yet, we had not created the animation, so we had created it by right clicking on this race folder, and from there, we had created from this new directory, and simply we had written anim. So by this way, we had created our animation folder, and then we had again right clicked on anim and created this bottom anim and side anim. After that, we had created or continued our project. So here we had also implemented our int, which is splash screen timer. So from there, we had casted our text view, and here we had casted our animation. So here animation casting. After that, we had set the animations to our text views, or we can say a layout. After that, we had created a new handler and added a post delete method in it, and again created new runnable. This had auto generated our run button or run method, which is return type void. So here we had created our activity to that, and then we had close our finish button, and then we had it was error here, so we had added this splash screen timer. So now our application is running in our device. Let's wait for it. So here it says Gradle build complete, and our application will be installed soon. So splash screen will be not shown more than 4 times. So here it is our placement. So by changing our placement from the center aligned to top, like by clicking this, and we had moved to top, and then we had created get support action bar dot height. So our action bar had hided. Now we are going to run our Android application again to see our changes. So first of all, closing our application and rerun our application, we will get our final output. So please make sure you subscribe this channel Android Tutorials for more interesting videos, and like this tutorial, that motivates us. Thanks for watching this tutorial. Now let's see our output. It had been generated. So here is our Android device. After that, here is our application, and you can see our animation and splash screen. After that, we are going to load our site by this process dialog and this process bar. So due to low internet connectivity, application website is not running, so we are not going to see that. Instead, so here it is, we had loaded it. Now closing all the apps and again running our application. So first of all, we need to clear all, and then after we are going to click on Fiverr. So here is our animation with our splash.